The CIL logo. Fade in to the Ed Roberts Awards logo. A man is sitting in his home office.
Good evening. My name is Stuart James, and I'm the executive director here at the Center for Independent Living in Berkeley. And I'd like to welcome you to the 5th annual Ed Roberts Day Awards. This is not where I expected to be on January 23rd, 2021. I mean, I expected to be at the UC Theater hanging out with friends and drinking a glass of wine and having a catered meal. But the Ed Roberts Day Awards are too important to cancel, and so with the help of some of our friends like the San Francisco Foundation and Square and Uber and, of course, all of you watching at home, we were able to pull this off. Been a challenging year for everyone, hasn't it? I mean, we've had to move all of our programming to virtual formats, and our staff have just done a wonderful job of sort of helping the community take it through this difficult time. We put together a very robust list of COVID-19 resources. You can find that on our website. We have a monthly PPE mask giveaway. It's no touch. You fill out a form again on the website and we put you on the list and we send that to you, I think, the first of every month. And then, of course, we've partnered with SCI groups, and that's spinal cord injury groups, to put care packages together. And we are most recently gave away 150 tablets to low-income individuals so they could access school and their family and healthcare and other essential services. But, you know, the CIL is about community. And that doesn't just mean the disability community. That means the entire community. And we realize that a lot of our friends and neighbors and family are struggling. Their businesses are struggling. So we wanted the Ed Roberts Award to be about helping them as well. And so what we did is we decided tonight to put together a way that every time you donate, we hope you donate tonight, you'll not only be helping us, but you'll be helping some of our friends. And so we'll be giving away gift cards to local restaurants, and we'll be giving away gift baskets full of artisan food. The theme for tonight's event is one that is near and dear to my heart, parenting. I became a dad about 2.5 years ago, and it's just been the most incredible experience of my life. I mean, my two girls, Sophia and Claire, they're just my joy. And, you know, when we came up with the Be Your Own Normal slogan, right, it was about taking ownership of the word normal. Normal is just what you see every day. So if you see people with disabilities out in the world, being part of the community, playing, working, falling in love, getting married, becoming parents, that becomes normal. And so, you know, what you're going to see tonight, we have 3 award winners that are going to receive the Ed Roberts Award. And they are not only wonderful advocates, but they are role models. They are parents. And they are fabulous parents. And so we're going to introduce those to you a little bit later. But first, I'd like to introduce a gentleman who's going to get the 2nd annual Joan Leon Award. Now, the Joan Leon Award goes to an individual or even an organization, maybe outside the disability community. They don't really have one, but they have assisted us in our mission over the years, and usually for a long period of time. Sometimes that could mean money. Sometimes it could just be a volunteer. But this gentleman has probably done both. He's been with us since the very earliest days of Judy Herman, Ed Roberts, and Kitty Cohn. And he's donated, you know, hundreds of thousands of dollars to our organization and the Ed Roberts campus as CEO of the San Francisco Foundation. So, you know, it's just my great honor to introduce to you and to present the 2nd annual Joan Leon Award to Mr. Martin Paley.
A picture of Martin Paley his name, and the Ed Roberts Awards logo in gold. Martin sits in his home.
I think my memory is that shortly after I arrived at the foundation in 74, which was just after the development of CIL in Berkeley, I got to become acquainted with the marvelous people who were providing leadership. People like Judy and Ed were among a few people that I came to know who were such of stature and had such a track record that almost when they came through the door, it was not whether you were going to grant the money, but how much. Clearly it was a civil rights issue, but it was a lot more. Not only did they focus on the services that people in the CIL were providing, but I think it was most important that they focused on policy. What policies do we need as a society in order to recognize and accommodate people with certain limitations, and to look beyond those limitations to see who are these people, what are they trying to say, what are they trying to do, and how can we and the rest of society be supportive?
Title card, Martin Paley, Joan Leon Award.
I'm delighted. I've known Joan for all these years. I think her seminal role in having the vision for the Ed Roberts Center and being able to make that happen is an extraordinary tribute to that woman. And to be able to be seen as an awardee in her name is a great honor. And I deeply appreciate what she has done, is doing, and will do for the Bay Area as a whole. And the work never gets done. And I think we need to continue to challenge ourselves to make our society open and accommodating and welcoming for people of a variety of capacities and needs. And I can't think of an organization that has made more of a contribution than the Center for Independent Living and the marvelous people who've been a part of it for so many years.
Fade out. Title card. Parents with Disabilities, Their Perspectives. Montage of parents speaking.
I'm a single dad. I have a daughter. She's 18 years old now. She's a happy, healthy kid. And she was 7 years old when I was injured. And she's 18 now, so I'm 11 years post-injury, and it is a great joy to be a parent.
Well, we were all in a car accident in 2009 where I became a quadriplegic. I have a spinal cord injury. And so they were able to be raised in this type of world. So they're really, they're very passionate also about disability rights and civil rights and justice and things like that.
My wife was 8 months pregnant when I got hurt, so I was in the hospital for a month at Valley Medical, and a week after I got out of the hospital, my first son was born. So, you know, life was absolutely crazy. Newly injured, adjusting to life in a wheelchair is pretty challenging, and then being a new parent was doubly challenging.
I think one of the greatest parts about being a parent is when my daughter will introduce me to maybe a friend or acquaintance of hers, and she'll say, "This is my cool dad," or give me a compliment that way. The things she will write in Christmas cards about how much I mean to her.
Having your kid, one of your kids, tell you they love you or hug you, just kind of that. That unconditional love and just having somebody look up to you is probably the coolest thing, I would think, for me.
There's so many things, but I think one of the main things is just to be able to mold human beings into being, productive adults and influencing them in certain things that are positive, like I was talking about earlier, about what they're interested in, and social justice is a big theme in our family. And so that is my favorite thing, is the influence of then watching them become such conscious human beings.
Fade Out, a Côte West commercial.
Hi, I'm Brett Hogan, co-owner and winemaker of Côte West, a small urban winery right here in Oakland. We think the work that the Center for Independent Living is doing for the disability community is incredibly important, and we love having the opportunity to support their work. We also want to thank the CIL for giving us the opportunity to collaborate with them and share this wine with you. Let me give you a very quick tour of our operations.
Brett walks into the cellar.
This is the cellar.
Brett walks around the stacked barrels.
These are our wine tanks. A bunch of the big equipment's down there.
Camera pans from Brett to the equipment, then back to him.
And this is where we age the barrels.
Brett picks up a wine bottle.
The wine that we're sharing with you is a 2019 Carignan Grenache blend. We hope you enjoy it.
Stuart in his home office.
Our first Ed Roberts Day Award winner is a guy I had the pleasure of working with and speaking to on a daily basis when I first came to CIO. He is an amazing advocate for parents with disabilities in his role at First Five Alameda. And I think more importantly, he's just an amazing role model. Brandon has an absolutely beautiful family and two amazing kids, and he's just a fantastic dad. It's my pleasure to present tonight's first Ed Roberts Day Award to my friend, Brandon Young.
A picture of Brandon Young, his name, and the Ed Roberts Awards logo in gold. Brandon sits in his house with his daughter.
My name is Brandon Young. I am the father of Simone and the father of Ziona. And I am a happily married family man. I think that's my title. Having two children who are under the age of five, now I see like all the ways that parents need support and all the ways that, you know, our society and our different agencies and departments aren't well equipped to supporting families. You know, obviously if you have enough resource, then you don't need a lot of support. But if you're a family, you know, like a working family, you need a lot of help to, particularly in the Bay Area, to just make it, you know, from week to week. I understand what families go through and how they need as much support, whether it be respite services or childcare, or looking at ways that childcare centers are expelling children because of behavioral issues and supporting families through that, or supporting childcare centers to come up with better ways to help families who have kids who have challenging behaviors. So everything that I do supports that, and that's the most important thing to me right now.
Title card, Brandon Young, Ed Roberts Award. Back to Brandon on camera.
People with disabilities are having families. They're raising children successfully, despite all the obstacles sort of arrayed against like individual people who have disabilities. We are finding ways to live a happy, well-adjusted life. I think that the society just needs to see that and then not necessarily applaud it. I don't think we need applause because we're doing what everybody else is doing. But I do think that people need to recognize this is what this American life looks like as well. And then once we get sort of that understanding, that then society can shift to accommodate more people with disabilities, more families with disabilities.
Fade out. Fade in title card. Parents of children with disabilities, their perspectives. Montage of parents speaking.
Josh was born with arthrogryposis. Not knowing what that was at all, he was in the hospital for one whole month in NICU.
When Owen was first diagnosed with SMA, I recall being at Children's Hospital and one of the social workers came into the room. This may have been the day he was diagnosed, so he was almost 2 years old. And I'll never forget what she said. She goes, "Well, you guys are about to be on one hell of a journey. There's two things, in my opinion, that are the most important aspects of Owen's life in the future: independence and mobility."
When Stuart was about three and he was in the hospital in New York City having rotting surgery, he has osteogenesis imperfecta, which is brittle bones. So he was having rotting surgery. And this cardiologist came up to me when I was waiting for him in surgery and asked me to go down to the clinic with her. And she took me down to the OI clinic and she introduced me to two children. One was a little boy who was riding, about four, riding around in a little tiny wheelchair, laughing and bumping into things and just really having a good time. And then she introduced me to a little girl about the same age who was laying flat in a sort of bed thing with bumpers all the way around. She was dressed beautifully like a little doll, but she could only see the ceiling. She wasn't able to interact with anyone. So when we went back upstairs to the waiting room, the doctor said to me, "So now, how are you going to raise Stuart?"
So I just remember also driving home from that one therapy appointment, just in tears, crying, because then I was thinking, am I being too stubborn? Like, maybe I am like pushing him too hard or expecting too much. You know, maybe I should give in and say okay to the wheelchair vendor. But then I came home and, you know, my husband and I talked and he's like, "Nope, we're just going to give it a few more months." And I'm like, "Okay, let's go." And he started walking.
When I went to the store with him, if he had a cast on for 2 or 3 weeks or so, people staring at me and I felt they were accusing me of child abuse, which wasn't true, but it was painful. When he was very young, it was painful.
What I worry for Owen is his health and his mortality, and how fragile he can be if he does get sick. And just knowing that he doesn't have the resources within his immune system to fight COVID or other diseases like the rest of his family does. But he definitely has the positive attitude to make it happen.
Fade out. A man stands in a factory.
Hi, everyone. My name is Brad Kinzer. I am the head chocolate maker here at Cho Chocolate, based in Berkeley, California. I'm here at our factory today and just wanted to say thank you so much for including us in this beautiful Ed Roberts virtual day to support the Center for Independent Living. We are just deeply inspired here by the work that you all have done over so many decades. And it's really an inspiration. We're a brand that's all about ideas and changing the world, and you know, through chocolate. Really, that starts with the farmer partners that we work with, all the way through to the products that we make. And I can't think of a bigger inspiration than the work that you all have done over so much time and so many generations. And please know that you know, we wish you the best in 2021, and we're so grateful to be included in today's awesomeness. So thank you so much, and be well.
Stuart in his home office.
Our next Ed Roberts Day Award winner is someone who played a bit of a role in my own life, though she probably doesn't realize it. I had the opportunity to meet Kira while I was still living in Beijing, and she came to China with her family to pick up their son, Ela. We became friends and I started following her on Facebook, seeing all these pictures of her all-American Midwestern family picnics and barbecues and daddy-daughter dances. And man, I just realized that was something I wanted to have in my own life. But Care is more than a role model. She's been a lifelong advocate and is the founder of the Disability Parenting Project, something I strongly encourage you to check out if you're a parent or wanting to be one. She has made a difference in the lives of hundreds, if not thousands, of people. It is my pleasure to present tonight's second Ed Roberts Award to Dr. Kira Ayers.
A picture of Dr. Ayers, her name, and the Ed Roberts Awards logo in gold. Dr. Ayers on camera.
I really just feel extremely grateful to be able to do this work. It crosses, you know, professional and personal spaces for me as well. My husband and I are both disabled parents. And as my kids get older, 3.5, 10, and 13 now, we as a family have more conversations about how the disability culture impacts our life as a family. So to be able to work in that space and do my best to make a difference in it is something I'm extremely grateful for. The Disabled Parenting Project, it has a place for in research, but it also has a place in grassroots and community-based support, peer-to-peer. We really identified a need in multiple spaces to support parents with disabilities, and we felt like that the best way to address that would be something from within our community itself. I have three kids, one with a disability and two without disabilities, and there's a lot of myth-busting or dismantling the preconceptions related to parenting with a disability. I mean, I think the first one maybe is just the concept that we as disabled people would become parents or want to become parents. There was, even when I was very visibly pregnant both times, people would express confusion or disbelief. It was as if they couldn't compute both kind of pieces of my identity, being visibly disabled and being visibly pregnant. At this point, there's still more than 20 states that directly discriminate against parents with disabilities in their various codes. So as an example, in Ohio, it states that a child can be removed from the custody of a parent on the status of disability alone. So just on the presence of disability, technically my children could be removed. There wouldn't need to be any evidence of abuse or neglect. In Ohio, as well as other states, we have legislation in process to prohibit that discrimination against parents with disabilities.
Title card, Dr. Kara Ayers, Ed Roberts Award. Back to Dr. Ayers on camera.
It is such an honor to receive the Ed Roberts Award. Ed Roberts has been a longtime hero of mine. To receive this award related to work that is closest to my heart, disabled parenting and being part of that community and supporting us to grow as a community, is something that I feel greatly honored to accept and also just committed and motivated to continue to work hard in this space.
Title card. Parents with Disabilities, Their Perspectives. Montage of Parents Speaking.
There's a lot of judgments when it comes to parenting and when it comes to people with disabilities. For example, when I was injured, I was asked to relinquish my parental rights because I could no longer be a parent, which is ridiculous. And so a lot of people will go against you and say, oh, you can't be a parent, or they'll judge the way that you parent your kids, or they'll say, you know, how are you going to do that? And just don't listen to the noise.
I think if people want to have kids, I think they should 100% do it, whether they have disability or any other kind of, you know, whether it's a spinal cord injury or any other kind of disability. Disabilities don't determine how good of parents you are.
If you're thinking about having kids, talk to other couples who have kids and ask them how they do it. Ask them what's worked for them. Ask them what hasn't worked for them. And through the process of identification there, you might be able to model their successes and learn and avoid the pitfalls that they had to go to.
I've never let my disability hold me back on on being a good parent or trying to be a good parent. So I would 100% recommend it. It's the greatest reward.
There is more to parenting than having an able body or to having, or to being, or not identifying as having a disability. To be a parent, you need your heart and your mind, and you need just to be present for your children. So again, you know, don't listen to the noise, be confident, and do your best.
Fade out. Oakland Honey Company commercial. A man cares for bees and gathers honey.
Oakland Honey Company, founded in 2016 by beekeeper and owner Ron Carter, provides locally produced, raw, natural honey. Each batch of harvested honey comes direct from hives located in the Oakland Hills that are tended to year-round using environmentally friendly beekeeping practices, creating a unique blend of natural flavors produced by bees foraging throughout the East Bay. Buying local, pure, natural honey ensures that many of the natural properties of raw honey, including royal jelly, bee pollen, and propolis, three major sources of antioxidants, vitamins, and minerals, are preserved. Oakland Honey Company products are never heated or treated and are bottled in sterilized glass jars. Thank you for supporting Oakland Honey Company and for helping to build a better Bay Area. Please visit oaklandhoneycompany.com to place an order and set up no-contact delivery. Thank you.
Stuart in his home office.
Can you imagine you come to the United States from the Ayers, you're 7 years old, you don't speak the language, the community around you doesn't speak the language you speak. You have a vision impairment. You get integrated into the public school at a time where that wasn't common. You eventually go to college and you land a job at the Department of Rehabilitation. A few years later, not too many years later, Governor Jerry Brown appoints you the director of the Department of Rehabilitation. A job that Ed Roberts himself once had. All the while, you're raising a family, children, grandchildren. That's our next Ed Roberts Award winner. Ladies and gentlemen, it's my pleasure to present the Ed Roberts Award to the current director of California's Department of Rehabilitation, Mr. Joe Xavier.
A picture of Joe Xavier, his name, and the Ed Roberts Awards logo. Joe on camera.
The thumbnail version of how I got here starts as being born in the Azores Islands, a group of islands off of the coast of Portugal. At the age of 7, we migrated immigrants to the United States, landed here in California, Sonoma County. One of 8 siblings, the only one with a disability, grew up in agriculture, milking cows, feeding calves, irrigating crops. Left the farm, went into the business enterprises program training for selling burgers and fries and bacon and eggs, and did that for about 14 years. Been a civil servant for the last 23 or so years. I have 3 adult children and 2 grandkids. I am the only one with the disability, but I can tell you that every single one of my family, both immediate and extended, as a result of my experience, has been exposed to disability. And so this ability for them is just a normal part of everyday life. It is not something that is weird or odd and or different. So myself as a person with a disability, as an individual who has benefited from the services provided by this department and so many of our partners, I have the chance at earning that family sustaining wage. There is nothing that is more rewarding than to have an individual say, thank you. When I came to you as a department providing the services you do, I did not believe in myself. You helped me not only to believe in myself, but to see the potential and the talent that I bring to the table. And today, I am providing for my family.
Title card, Joe Xavier, Ed Roberts Award. Back to Joe on camera.
First of all, I just want to thank CIL Berkeley for the work that they do, ensuring that people have the opportunity to live in their community with purpose and dignity. It is what Ed Roberts stood for. So I'm very honored. I am humbled to be a recipient of this award. I appreciate everything that it stands for and that it represents, and I'll continue to walk in the footsteps of Ed Roberts and make a difference for individuals with disabilities across our communities and our society.
Fade out. Colt Cracker's commercial opens with two women in an industrial kitchen.
Hi, my name is Diana Dar.
And I'm Katrina Durrell.
And together, we're the co-founders of Colt Crackers. We're a women-owned and women-run cracker company, and we hand-bake our artisan, organic, gluten-free crackers at the Berkeley Kitchen.
A different angle.
And I'd like to thank you for all your support of CIL, and here's to a better 2021 when we can all gather together.
Title card, Parents of Children with Disabilities, Their Perspectives. Montage of parents speaking.
I totally recommend parents, if at all possible, to have their children in a regular school and to provide whatever extra assistance they need, which the schools have to do now. So I did have some, you know, it was a little nerve-wracking to begin with, but it worked out really well. I mean, he did really well in school. He loved school and he made a lot of friends.
Josh had a little posse of friends that really protected him, which was so awesome. Seventh grade, eighth grade, you know, they protected him from the other kids, you know, coming in, they didn't grow up with Josh. And it was really, it like warmed my heart, say like in ninth grade in AP English when, you know, they would have to get up and turn in their assignments or something like that, you know, just literally as a matter of just habit, some of the kids would just grab his stuff and just, you know, go hand it in for him. It was just like the norm.
You gotta really approach them, meaning the authorities and even the teachers, and go, hey, we got a situation here. We all want to work towards the common goal to get a good education for our son. How can we do that together? And it takes a lot of patience, took a lot of patience. There were times when I was like, are they going to get those ramps? Oh, well, they're on order and they just didn't come in. You know, I had the option to say, hey, it's been 3 weeks before you got those ramps. You can't go over the curb to get into the preschool or the kindergarten. And instead I say, okay, I'm going to go make my own. And then when the manufactured ones come in, we'll use those. So you got to work together in these school systems. My advice to parents is do your best as you can to be nice and not focus on the law. Focus on the student. Focus on the person.
What it did for the school was the children that were in his class totally accepted him. They didn't worry about his disability. They'd ride around in his wheelchair. It was not a problem. So I think it's a great thing for children with disabilities to be integrated into the mainstream if possible. And it teaches them to be, how to be socially, you know, good with other children and how they have to just adjust sometimes themselves. I do think it's really valuable.
Fade out. Angeline's Louisiana Kitchen commercial starts with a woman in an industrial kitchen.
Hi everybody, it's Tempe from Angeline's Louisiana Kitchen. I'm gonna give you a little tour, a behind the scenes tour of the kitchen. Not many people get to see what it's like back here because usually it's very bustling and busy. You might know us best for our fried chicken with tasso ham gravy and mashed sweet potatoes, but this is really where I think all the love happens. Let's see if I can get you in there. This is where we make our gumbo, our jambalaya. These dishes take all day. They cook for a really long time so that we can get a really good depth of flavor in them. Some of you might be eating our food right now, and for that, we thank you. We also want to thank the Center for Independent Living for inviting us to be a part of this virtual Ed Roberts Day event. We are really proud to have been included. And we hope to see you all in 2021, and we hope for more partnership in the future. Thanks.
Fade out. Stuart in his office.
Finally, we're going to close out this evening's activities with a Lifetime Achievement Award. Tonight, we'll be honoring an individual that has been pioneering the rights for parents with disabilities for almost 4 decades. It's my pleasure to present a 2021 Ed Roberts Lifetime Achievement Award to Dr. Megan Kirschbaum. Dr. Kirschbaum's achievements speak for themselves. Founder of Through the Looking Glass, an organization which works to lessen the obstacles society places for parents with disabilities. Founder of the National Center for Parents with Disabilities, the first of its kind in the world. There are few people in this country, in the world, that can say they've done as much for as long to normalize parenting with disability as Megan. Ladies and gentlemen, it is my great pleasure to present a 2021 Ed Roberts Lifetime Achievement Award to Dr. Megan Kirschbaum.
A picture of Dr. Kirschbaum, her name, and the Ed Roberts Awards logo in gold.
I got involved with the disability independent living movement originally in 1973 with my husband, Hal Kirschbaum, who had MS and was one of the behind the scenes pioneers in the independent living movement. And I started working at Center for Independent Living originally with couples and then later as a family therapist. I started in 1974 and worked there for 8 years until Hal and I started Through the Looking Glass in 1982. We trained more than 225,000 professionals all over the country and in other countries. Our goal was to improve practice and reduce the obstacles faced by parents with disabilities. Well, there's very deep bias about parenting by people with disabilities. It takes a great deal to counteract it. And we've been working at counteracting that bias in multiple systems with multiple kinds of professionals for 38 years now. It's a much deeper bias than regarding against people with disabilities in employment or even in sexuality. Parenting is the new frontier of disability rights. It really does reveal many areas where there are still gaps in having a full life when you're a person with a disability, and gaps that haven't been dealt with sufficiently. Services and resources that have been developed for people with disabilities assume they are not going to be parents or that they are not parents. And therefore, that causes numerous difficulties, obstacles for families parented by people with disabilities. I've had other awards, but this award feels meaningful to me because it's where I started my work with families with disabilities. As the issue of parents with disabilities is becoming more of a focus, I would like to see the work that Through the Looking Glass has done be built upon, and so that other places who are developing new services can benefit from our long work, our expertise, you know, the mistakes we made, the successes we had. That's what I would like.
Fade out. Stuart in his office.
Well, that's it. I hope you all enjoyed the 5th annual Ed Roberts Day Award and learning a little bit about our wonderful slate of honorees. I want to thank all the families who participated tonight and were willing to share their stories. I want to thank our sponsors and, of course, all of you at home for making tonight even possible. I want to thank my staff for working so hard this past year, helping us overcome many, many challenges we faced in 2020. We still have a lot of work to do, and I have great faith that you will help move the organization forward. Been tough, but we're looking forward to a better 2021. I want to wish all of you a happy new year. Thank you for joining us. Good night.
Fade out. Ed Roberts Awards logo appears. Title card. Thank you for joining us this evening. Sponsor logo. San Francisco Foundation. Retha Robinson, the foundation director, stands outside.
Good evening, everyone. Hey, Martin. This is Retha, your old friend from the San Francisco Foundation. Just want to congratulate you on receiving the Ed Roberts Award. You are so well-deserved, and I'm happy people are still acknowledging the great gifts that you are bringing to community. Congratulations again, and thank you, Center for Independent Living, for honoring Martin Paley, my old boss and friend from the San Francisco Foundation.
Sponsor logo, Uber. Sponsor logo, Square. Organizations mentioned tonight, San Francisco Foundation, First 5 Alameda County, Disabled Parenting Project, Department of Rehabilitation, Through the Looking Glass. Gift cards from Angeline's Louisiana Kitchen, Kamal, Lucia's, Ramen Shop, Shinmai, organizations mentioned tonight, San Francisco Foundation, First 5 Alameda County, Disabled Parenting Project, Department of Rehabilitation, Through the Looking Glass. Sponsor logo, San Francisco Foundation. Sponsor logo, Uber. Sponsor logo, Square. Organizations mentioned tonight, San Francisco Foundation, First 5 Alameda County, Disabled Parenting Project, Department of Rehabilitation, Through the Looking Glass. Goods and baskets from Cote West. Colt Crackers. Oakland Honey Company. Proyecto Diaz Coffee. Cho Chocolate. Organizations mentioned tonight, San Francisco Foundation, First 5 Alameda County, Disabled Parenting Project, Department of Rehabilitation, Through the Looking Glass. Sponsor logo, San Francisco Foundation. Sponsor logo, Uber. Sponsor logo, Square. Title card, 5th Annual Ed Roberts Day Awards, Saturday, January 23rd. The CIL logo.